Good morning students. So in acid and bases we have read about the indicators, we have read about the natural indicator and the laboratory indicator, and you must have remembered the name of natural indicators. This is the litmus paper, the China rose solution, turmeric solution, all these are the natural indicators which are used to detect whether the given solution is acidic or basic in nature without tasting it. Okay, we have already read about the properties of acids and bases. So today I am going to show you an activity in which you will be knowing that litmus paper is used as an indicator to test whether the given solution is acid or a base. And do you remember, students, the litmus paper is made from what? I will show you the litmus paper. Here I have a red litmus paper and this is a blue litmus paper. Okay, this is whole lot of strips with me. I'm having these strips. We will take one strip from this and we will perform an activity. So this is red litmus paper and this one is blue litmus paper, and it is prepared from lichens. Okay, we have already read about lichens, what are they and how this paper is made. So we will start our activity. For this I have taken two bowls having a little bit water in it. Okay, now what I will do here, I am having a soda, baking soda, jisko hum log meetha soda bolte hain. Now I am going to add small amount of baking soda into water. We will see whether it is a base or a acid. Okay, now I'll mix it. So the solution is ready, and here is a vinegar. Okay, it is a vinegar bottle, and I am going to pour this vinegar in my water and see whether it is an acid or a base. I hope these two things you must be having in your home kitchens. Vinegar is also used in manchurian, chowmein, all these things. Okay, so in this bowl I have taken the vinegar solution, and in this bowl I have taken the baking soda solution. Now what I will do, first I will take red litmus paper. This is red litmus paper. I have taken a strip, and now we will put it in our baking soda solution. So in this bowl I took the baking soda. Can you see the color change? Can you see the color change? See, my red litmus paper, it turned into blue. And you can see on the screen, if red litmus is changed to blue, that means it is a base. It is a base. Can you see over here? It is a base. Okay, so it's a base. And if I put same red litmus paper in the vinegar solution, let's see what happens. See, is there any color change, students? Is there any color change? It remained like this only. So the red litmus paper is used to detect whether the given solution is a base. If it is a base, then the red litmus paper will change into blue color, and if it is an acid, the red litmus will remain red. Okay, so this was the test with the red litmus paper. Now let's see what the blue litmus paper does with these solutions. So I'll take again two strips. So I have taken the two strips, students. Now what will happen, I will take this blue litmus paper and dip it in my baking soda solution. Okay, let's see, is there any change? Can you see, is there any change? Is there any change, students? No. Okay, now I will take this blue litmus paper and dip it in vinegar solution. Okay, see, the color is changing, students. Can you see over here? See, the blue litmus paper changed into red. That means, you can see on the slide also, blue litmus paper changes to red if it is an acid, and it remains blue if it is a base. So I hope from this litmus paper test you might be very clear that this solution is acidic, okay, because it changed the blue litmus paper to red, and this baking soda solution is basic in nature because it changed red litmus to blue. So from this activity, I hope all of you can easily remember what are the color changes with the two different litmus paper. Thank you. We will meet again in another video. Okay. Thank you, students.